First, you have one thing to do. Go to the MCT10 software and run this. You can run the software from the Windows Start menu, or you can run directly from the desktop shortcut icon of the software you have installed on your computer. Now, take a USB A to Type B communication cable, also known as a printer cable, and connect it to the Danfoss VFD. Plug the Type B end into the communication port on the drive's control unit, which you'll find right here. Next, plug the USB A end of the cable into your laptop. Once connected, the communication with the drive will be established. Once the connection between your drive and computer is established, you'll see the USB 1 option appear under Network. Before connecting, this option was hidden. Be sure that your connection is stable and everything is set up correctly. When you connect the drive to your computer using the MCT10 software, it automatically receives a backup from the drive. No extra steps are needed. The backup starts on its own. Under the USB 1 option, you'll see the information for the 1.5 kilowatt FC302 drive. Next, click on the drive information under the USB option. You'll see an option labeled Read from the Drive. However, there's no need to click this because the software has already read the parameters from the drive automatically. This way, you avoid duplicating the same task. To download the parameters, click on the Copy option. This will read the parameters from the drive, allowing you to paste them in the Project section as a backup. Note that using the Read Data from the Drive option alone won't let you paste the parameters into the project. In the project, if there are any existing drive parameters, please delete them to avoid confusion. Then, right-click and paste the copied parameters into the project. Now, expand the project and go into the Parameters section. You can review all the data here. Make sure you've selected the correct Danfoss drive parameters. First, to verify the drive address, go to the Profi drive option in parameter number 9. This will show you the Profibus address. Next, navigate to ID number 9118 to check the node address.
Next, open the File menu in the MCT10 software, select Save As, and rename the backup file using the Drives tag. This way, you can easily locate the backup data.